What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Kobucks. Today we are in Kodiak, Alaska, which is where I grew up, and I'm gonna take you out spearfishing with me on one of the places that I grew up diving all the time. I'm just looking for some greenling or maybe some flounders. Technically they're called rock sole, but people usually recognize them as flounders. Just something to cook up tonight. Jasmine is gonna be here, Jade's sister, and Jade. And so I'm really excited. I hope you guys enjoy. All right, so I'm gonna do a voiceover to let you know what I'm thinking on this dive and give you some tips if you want to go spear some greenling. Before I even made my first dive, I spotted a nice-sized greenling hiding in the kelp. Since it was so shallow, I decided to shoot from the surface instead of doing a duck dive and risk scaring off the fish. Nice shot, didn't ruin any meat. Now these fish aren't usually targeted by line fishermen, which makes sense when there's so many better tasting fish in Alaskan waters. But this is the main fish I grew up hunting here on Kodiak. You don't have to go deep to find them, they're not difficult to shoot, and they're super abundant in most places. The hardest part about shooting them is finding them. Normally I'll just go down to the bottom on the sand, right where it meets the rocks and kelp, like in this clip. And if there's any around, they'll swim right over to check me out. And this is exactly what happens right here on this clip. I'm on the bottom looking around and I spot one peeking out at me from on top this rock. I swing my gun over slowly and line up for the shot. My shaft warped a bit during the shot, which usually indicates a bent shaft, but I checked it after the dive and this wasn't the case. So if any of you have an idea, please let me know. On the way in, I dove down into this sand patch to look for sole. I see a little school of candlefish right here, and then when I look back to my right, I see a pair of eyes in the sand looking up at me. What's kind of cool about the greenling is their meat is pretty blue. Oh. Yeah, a little candlefish. I'm like, summit. Eating good tonight. Yeah. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe if you'd like to. It means a lot. I really appreciate all your support. I'm really excited about these next few videos that I'll be putting out for you. Got some awesome adventures planned. Me, Jade, and Jasmine are going out to my parents' setnet site for a few days here tomorrow, actually. So probably by the time you see this, I will be editing that video, and I'm really excited about it. The silver salmon are starting to run pretty well out there. And there's a chance I might be able to land a world record silver salmon. I'm just gonna keep skinning these up, deboning them. Cooking up fish like this that I just got right out in front of the house, this is like how I started diving. This is what 15-year-old Max was up to. It's pretty fun being able to just do it like I used to again, just getting out there, shoot some fish, cook it up for dinner. That is what got me so excited about spearfishing in the first place, is just going out, catching your own food. I mean, that's really what it's all about, and having a great fucking time doing it, you know?
Ringing the dinner bell for the eagle, yeah. All the fish are gone from earlier.
Oh, hey, Summit. How's it going, buddy? How's it going?
He's still getting used to me. Or maybe he's a little camera shy. So what I'm gonna do for this cook is I'm gonna do egg, panko, and flour. And we're going to mix a little bit of salt and pepper in the flour. And flip them in the flour, dip them in the egg, coat them in panko, and boop, straight in the fryer.
Oh, okay. That's a whole pile of them.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the, like, when my babysitter, or some babysitter was, like, babysitting me, and I was like,
Erica Horn.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Erica Horn or Sarah Horn?
I think it was Sarah Horn. Yeah. I was like, I caught some kelp fish. You guys thought it was just kelp.
Yeah.
Not fish.
Oh. He could barely, he'd never caught a fish really by himself. And he went down here and was just like casting. Yeah, he went down to the beach and he was fishing. And did you catch any? Yeah, I caught kelp fish. And I go, oh, that's cool. And I just thought he was catching literally kelp, right?
Yeah.
He goes, yeah, I put him in a bucket.
You're like, okay, where's the bucket?
You wouldn't normally put kelp in a bucket.
It looks like a garbage can. You didn't even put it in a bucket. Did you put it in the garbage can in the background?
Probably. Yeah. Let's see what this is like.
When him and Morgan would come up to Kodiak, they just put hooks over the water, you know, the side all the time. And there's times the whole bottom's just covered with yellowfin sole. And they're really good to eat, but mm-hmm. you know, you don't get very much out of them. And they just like start catching like piles and piles and piles of them. And we'd be like, oh man, that's a lot of filleting. And yeah. Then it was a great relief when they could fillet them themselves.
Okay, that's pretty good.
And then they're like, oh, after they figured it out, they're like, no, we don't want to keep the little ones. Yeah, that's what we've been trying to tell you.